Hey y'all, hey, it's your girl B-Bot Art, and I'm back with another video with a Rugrats inspired tutorial. If you want to know how I achieve this look into this amazing beat, then stay tuned. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and click the bell to be notified when I post new videos. Let's hop into this beat, y'all. So for today's inspired look, I used it solely BH Cosmetics Take Me Back to Brazil palette. As you can see, I used it this light blue to serve as a transition color. Whatever works for me might not work as best for you, but what I like to do is to pack that color into my lid first, then taking that brush and blending that color in towards my lid windshield wiper motion. Next, as being displayed, I'm taking a darker blue, packing that in towards my crease while blending it out seamlessly windshield wiper motion. Also, you guys, if you haven't already, go ahead and make sure you check out my last video on my best friend stealing my man. Make sure you comment, like, and let me know how you like the video. Next, as shown, I'm going in with a more darker blue and I'm packing that same color on top of that previous color from before, just warming that blue up to make it look more nicer and more vivid. Now I'm going back into those two light blue colors and I'm going to apply it to the top of my lid just so it can look more nicely blended. Please forgive me for being a little jokey, but now I'm taking that LA Girl Pro Conceal in the color Creamy Beige just to serve as a cut crease for me. A little tip for my hooded chicks like me, all you have to do is just apply a little concealer of your choosing towards your lid, look up, and it will serve as a pointer just to show you where to start from and an easy guide. Also, if you're new to the channel or if you forgot to check out this video, make sure to go check this video, you guys. I promise you, you get the laugh of your life. It's story time. Also, get ready with me. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and let me know how you guys are loving this channel and loving that video. Next, I'm using some NYX white jumbo pencil just to serve as a creamy white base so the eyeshadow can pop a little bit more. I'm going back in with that Take Me Back to Brazil palette with that beautiful orange color, and I'm just packing it as well, blending that orange into that crease that I cut it before. Now I'm about to use that same dark blue from before and just pack it on towards the outer crease, blending that in with that orange just to kind of cut the crease a little bit more. Now I'm going in with Shot Miss A liquid eyeliner and I'm just going to go off camera while I apply that. Next, I went into my inner tear duct and I used Such a Cutie Cosmetics Neon Green Loose Eyeshadow. Guys, make sure to go check out her website located in the description box as well with the other items used in this video. She is such a sweetie and a black-owned businesswoman. Go check her out. Okay, next, as shown, I'm using some Afterglow Absolute New York Illuminating 3D Liquid Highlighter, and I blend that in with my Garnier Moisture Rescue, and I just use that as a primer. Then I'm taking my Maybelline Fit Me in the color 360, color name Mocha, and I just apply it onto my face using this brush and my setting spray, and just blending that foundation in as so. If you're not following my social media already, go ahead and follow me on Instagram at xbeatbyari. I promise you, you won't regret. After applying my foundation, now I'm going in with that same LA Girl Pro Conceal from before, color creamy beige, and I'm just using it to conceal and construct my face and contour as well. With that concealer, I like taking it as shown. I like to create a triangle effect towards my forehead, on top of my cheekbones, and on the bridge of my nose, so it can be a little bit more easier to conceal and construct. Then I take my beauty blender from Shop Miss A, which is only $1, and I spray it to get it nice and hydrated with my setting spray before, and I just blend it out seamlessly in a direction that I have it outlined and contoured to. Make sure to go check out my Snapchat named Pretty Ariel for some awesome, funny videos. Now, as you can see, I mixed it some RK setting powder with some Ben Nye setting powder in the color banana, and I just went on top of where I contour with that LA Girl Pro Concealer. Next, I end up using some BH Cosmetics, some dark foundation. I can't quite remember the color, but I will have it located in the description box, and I just use that to snatch my face and just create a dimension for my face. Next, I'm taking a fluffy brush that I got from BH Cosmetics Rose Quartz Collection, and I just end up spraying it with some of my setting spray and just knocking off and dusting some of that setting spray off of my face. So I ended up going off camera just dusting away all the setting powder, as well blending some of that foundation that I used to contour my face. Next, I went back in with that NYX White Jumbo Cream Pencil, just going on my bottom lid, so when I apply my eyeshadow that the eyeshadow can appear more pigmented and pop more. So in the next few clips, you will see that I will be using majority of the same colors that I used to the top lid, and I'll be applying it towards my bottom lid. The only color that I did different was using that purple, just to kind of bring it out some more. And I really thought that purple would look awesome with this look. So yeah, that's what you will be seeing in the next few clips. So after applying the colors that I wanted, I ended up going back in with that purple because I felt like it got a little bit lost in it. And yes, like that, I thought that purple was so beautiful. And then I end up taking a small brush like so and just end up blending those colors out seamlessly. After applying the shadow towards the bottom lid, I end up going in with my BH Cosmetics Tropicana palette, and I went in with a silver just to create a highlight, and I always use this as always for a highlight for my face. So for the lips, I end up using some Shop Miss A lip liner, as well as some matte liquid lipstick. I can't remember the name of the lipstick, but I will have all that in the description, so do not fret, y'all. Like I said, I will have all that listed in the description. But after applying it, I end up feeling like that it was a little bit too drying. So after the clip, I end up using some Nika K lip gel, flavor rosemary, and I will have that in the description box as well. And I end up going off camera while doing it because it wasn't really to my liking. So I end up cutting off camera, and you will see in the next clip like the ending of everything all together. Yes, guys, it's come to the end of my conclusion. I end up loving and admiring how this look ended up coming out. If you did as well, make sure you like, comment, hit that bell to be notified when I post new videos, and let me know how I'm doing on this YouTube journey, guys. I thank you all so much for the support, and I will catch y'all guys in my next video, love.
I'm hoping this will help you understand. In her voice, baby, why you got a thug on me? Damn, why, babe, why you can't just fucking love on me? I don't know, I tried. The fact I show you a and you don't show it back. It's like you scared to be with me the way you hold it back. Trust me. In my words, fuck the stress, I want you at your best. The fact you here show you down, I gotta confess. I tell you, just let me apologize, I wanna progress. Just listen. Yeah, you can lay your trust on me.